Hi everybody, it's Dr. O, and this is my self-care tip for today. We'll start with a quote, if it doesn't challenge you, it doesn't change you. And of course, we're talking about exercise, and when it comes to exercise, you really have to physically challenge your body in order for it to change you. Okay, so we talked about there are many benefits of exercise, and today we're going to focus on physical health. And I've put in here a chart or a graph that shows the United States. The number one killer, the thing that more people die from than anything else, it's not AIDS, it's not gun violence, it's not traffic accidents, it's heart disease. Heart disease is the number one killer in America by far. 40 to 50% of Americans will die from heart disease. Now, heart disease has many factors. There are many factors that cause heart disease, but one of the best and simplest ways to reduce your risk of heart disease is to adopt an active lifestyle. On this chart, the darker the color red, the greater the number or the percentage of heart disease cases are. And if you look at this, if you can zoom in here and you look at Kentucky, you'll see right in the area where we live, it's very dark red. Some of the highest rates of the nation are right where we live. So we have to take some steps to protect ourselves and lower our risk from heart disease. And so a great way to lower your risk is to engage in regular physical exercise. Last time we talked about 10,000 steps as a great starting point for starting an exercise program. You try to take 10,000 steps every day. Today I'm going to encourage you to do something a little bit greater, take on a greater challenge, and to transition from thinking of yourself as a walker who is taking 10,000 steps a day to setting a goal of getting 30 minutes of cardio exercise every day. Now, what do we mean by cardio exercise? Cardio exercise is when you increase your heart rate, you get your heart rate elevated much higher than you would if you were just walking. When you're truly engaged in cardio exercise, your breath will be panting. In fact, it's hard to carry on a conversation or talk to somebody because you're breathing so heavily. And also, your body is generating, burning a lot of energy, and you'll be sweating. And so you know you're doing cardio when you get to that panting and sweating phase. If you can't talk comfortably, if your body's feeling challenged, that's great. You're at the cardio stage. Now, usually 30 minutes of cardio translates to more physical exercise, more fitness than does the 10,000 steps. And so we've saved some time here. We talked about 10,000 steps usually takes about 90 minutes. If you can do 30 minutes of cardio, that saves you some time. Now, the traditional kinds of cardio are things like jogging or cycling or swimming, and some of those things might not be available to you right now. You can also get your cardio in various kinds of exercise classes. I'm sure you've heard of things like step aerobics or Zumba, and so these cardio classes are a great way to get in your cardio. Now, you might be saying, wait a minute, I can't go to the gym. How am I going to do cardio classes? Well, I'm reluctant to endorse any particular product, but here's one that I've had good luck with that we've started. You've probably heard of Peloton. Peloton is a whole system where you can buy some fancy exercise equipment and it links up to studios in New York and London, and you can use these bikes and treadmills and all this kind of stuff. Well, you don't have to buy all that equipment. They actually have an app that goes right on your phone, or you can create an account online. And right now, they have a free 90-day trial for their app. Nothing costs you nothing for the next 3 months. And on the app, there's tons of pre-recorded classes. And so anytime you want to, anytime, day or night, you can go on the app and you can search for all different kinds of classes. Now, some of the classes we're talking about today, the cardio classes, they're listed here on the app. And there are all kinds of variety of things. Very interesting classes. They have, you can choose your music. They have classic music or dance music, or I'm not classic, I meant classic rock music, dance music, 80s hits, all that kind of stuff. So you can choose your music, you can choose your intensity, you can choose your activity. All that stuff is freely available. The teachers, the class leaders are very energetic and they really keep you motivated. Okay, so we signed up for the Peloton app, and when we did, our original goal was to take 90 classes in 90 days. Thought that would be a great accomplishment. It turns out that was way too easy. Most days, we're doing 2 10-minute meditation classes, and then when we get ready to exercise, we'll do a 5-minute warm-up class, and a 15-minute cycling class, and then we'll do a 30-minute strength class. So on any given day, we're doing as many as 5 classes. We're easily going to do 90 classes in 90 days. In fact, I'm hoping that we do something closer to 300 or 400 classes in the coming 90 days. All right. And so remember, no matter what your exercise goal is, track and monitor your progress. It is very motivating to see those X's on the calendar, X-ing, checking off the days when you've done your exercise. And have a motto, don't break the chain. Consistency is more important than intensity. As long as you're doing something every day, you will begin to develop this habit of becoming an exerciser, becoming a person who is fit and healthy.